Now, the South African government has assured that perpetrators of the recent attacks on Africans, including Nigerians living in South Africa and their businesses, will be brought to book. The South African High Commissioner to Nigeria, Bobby Moro, gave the assurances while playing host to several youth groups in Abuja in an effort to finalize cultural exchange programs between youths and students from both countries as a strategy to bringing an end to these attacks. Monroe assured that no stone will be left unturned in the government's effort to bring to an end a wave of violence which has seen property worth millions of naira destroyed and several African residents in the country killed by several angry South Africans.
In the recent past, we have engaged ourselves in an academic exercise of trying to define whether these are xenophobic attacks or acts of criminality. Either way, it is wrong. And it must stop. Engaging in an academic exercise to define takes more time from us, time that we are supposed to be using to resolve these challenges. It doesn't matter whether perpetrators of violence are law enforcement officers, are senior people wherever they work, or they are people who are well known. The law of South Africa is quite very clear. Regardless of who you are, the law takes its course. So the government is making sure that the perpetrators of violence are brought to book through the law enforcement agencies such as the South African police services. We cannot sit idle when the country is burning. The president has rightly condemned acts of violence against people who come from other communities. You don't simply kill somebody because they are from another country. This is what the president said last night. And I want to reiterate that what has happened does not reflect the sentiments of the majority of South Africans. South Africans are peace-loving people. South Africans love Nigerians as much as Nigerians love South Africans. Nigeria is home to me as well, as much as South Africa is home to you as well. So we cannot be seen to be colluding with certain elements who have harbored agendas within society to destroy these cordial relations that we are enjoying with Nigeria. They will not succeed under the current administration. And the president was very unequivocal in his statement last night to say that this must stop, and it will stop.
Now, drama at the South African High Commission in Abuja as youth groups clash over strategy to bring an end to the wave of violence in South Africa that has affected several African residents, including Nigerians. While a faction led by the National Youth Council of Nigeria had presented a proposal which includes a cultural exchange program between Nigerian students and youth groups with their counterparts in South Africa, this did not go down well with the National Association of Nigerian Students, NANS, which insists there will be no negotiation until the killings in South Africa is brought to an end. The president of NANS accused the South African government of being complicit in the violence.
Identify yourself.
We are not selling.
We are not beating him now. See him now. Leave him now.